Good afternoon. My name is Joe Montoya, J-O-E, M-O-N-T-O-Y-A. I'm the Division Chief of Investigations for the Denver Police Department. What I want to talk to about today is the opening day for Colorado Rockies tomorrow. First and foremost, we're extremely excited to have people downtown again. I know this is, they haven't been able to hold a regular opening day for 2 years now, so this is the first time in 2 years they're going to be able to do it. So we're excited about that. I know the community's excited to get downtown. It's going to be a nice day. They're playing the Dodgers. That's always a big draw, so we're expecting a lot of people out there. I always like to start with the most important piece for us is people getting to and from the game safely. Come down, enjoy yourselves, but be responsible. If you're going to indulge in alcoholic beverages, please use rideshare, public transportation, be safe in your travels. Be cognizant of the mass number of pedestrians are going to be on foot downtown, people on scooters, people on bikes. We always want to make sure that everybody's careful in the way they get to and from the game. The Denver Police Department, we're going to have a large we're gonna have a lot of people out there. We're gonna be very visible. A lot of it is for just the community relations piece. We want to be able to engage with people coming to and from the games. District 6 is gonna have a community table on the 2100 block of Blake. So any people going to and from the games that have questions about anything pertaining to the game or anything in the area or need help finding directions anywhere, please stop by and engage with them. We're going to have plenty of resources out there to respond to any type of issues that might occur. Like similar with the Major League All-Star Game, we are paying attention to what's going on and determining, if there was any threats that we deemed could, disrupt this event. We have the resources available to address that. I'm going to leave it open now for any questions that you might have.
Do you have people, extra staffing or maybe overtime in order to have that bigger presence here?
We do. So we utilize all our additional resources that we do for large events. District 6, Commander Bowser indicated that they canceled days off for the entire district, so they'll be fully staffed in the district. And that's not only to address the game, but to address all the other issues that for the entire district that might occur. So, yes. The table, I believe, is just for the game. The staffing will be heavy throughout the weekend. We expect it's going to be a big weekend. We also always partner with our community partners, with the Colorado Rockies, and with some of our federal partners as well that are going to be out assisting us that this weekend. Yeah, so I'd say, basically from Union Station to the ballpark, we'll have a pretty visible presence there. As always, we will have people in and out of Union Station paying attention to what's going on there. But the majority of it is going to be within the proximity of the ballpark.
What kind of activities do you guys look out for specifically, just for any suspicious activity?
Well, as always, we're paying attention to any people that have bad intentions. Any indication of someone being armed, we would always look into that to determine what is going on with that situation, whether they're legally armed or not. With that, I'd like to say that anybody attending the game, anybody that's in that area, please, if you see something, say something. There's going to be plenty of uniformed officers around. If there's something just doesn't look right to you, whether it's an individual, a person, or just a suspicious package or something, please bring it to their attention right away so we can get the resources in there to deal with that.
With big crowds, do you guys also utilize drones and other things like that?
We don't utilize drones, no. And we do pay attention to drone activity. If somebody was circling around that we don't recognize, then we try to look into determining where that's being generated from. Okay, thank you.